How's everybody doing tonight? Good? Great. So, I'm taking these self-defense classes. After about 10 weeks, $50 a pop, the instructor says to me, "Oh, Steve, by the way, use this only if you get attacked." Yeah, right. Like you go to medical school just in case there's an emergency, huh? Hell no. I'm going to use what I know. I'm going to kick some butt. It's like, I said, "No tomato on my burger." Yeah! Oh, I don't think I'll be making that mistake again. It's like my grandma. She made me these oatmeal cookies. I must have told Grandma 100 times, "Grandma, I don't like oatmeal cookies." Why not? Why not? I don't think Granny's gonna be making that mistake again. Right, Granny? All right. All righty. How you doing? How's everybody tonight? Good? That's good. Did you ever notice that when little kids get embarrassed, they always lift up whatever they have over their head? Like, little boys will pick up their jackets and little girls will lift their dresses way up over their head. I don't think we ever should have stopped this behavior as adults. So you're a chick looking for a job. You go into the interview, just lift the dress up over your head and say, "I want this job, I need this job." It's just a theory. May not be true, but don't blame me if it works. I was in New York City recently. Man, cops sure are different there. I mean, they don't care how fast you drive in New York. You could be doing 50 miles an hour down Fifth Avenue with a beer between your legs, a seatbelt hanging out the window, running all these red lights. If a cop sees that, he's gonna say, "Bring me a donut on your way back, would ya?" It's much different here in California. I got stopped the other day in Beverly Hills. And I said, "What's the problem, officer?" "Your right speaker's out."